Early figures show in-store shopping on Black Friday in the U.S. was down more than 50% from last year.
COVID is causing more and more people to turn to laptops instead of the mall. But beware, online Grinches are out to ruin your holiday, and online gift exchanges with your friends could leave you vulnerable. NBC2 investigator Evan Dean shows you how to avoid losing your money.
In downtown Fort Myers, it's beginning to look a lot like Christmas.
So you guys into the Christmas shopping now?
But at Enjoy Boutique.
Are you local or?
Owner Tim Ferguson isn't getting a holiday rush.
Well, definitely sales are down. We're not seeing as many shoppers.
The main reason why more people are doing this, shopping online this Christmas. But could your money be at risk?
81% of people who do not do research lose money.
The Better Business Bureau says be careful if a deal seems too good to be true. Make sure where you're buying from is legit.
Scammers and illegitimate businesses can advertise just like legitimate companies. They can do ads at the top of search engines. They can advertise on social media sites.
Speaking of social media, watch out for those online gift exchanges, like one called Secret Sister. It claims you can send just one gift, but somehow receive up to 36 in return. The BBB says this is actually a pyramid scheme.
Usually one person receives that gift while the others do not. Mm-hmm. The Federal Trade Commission considers this not a legal activity to follow. And if you're not engaged with the right people, or if a friend is spoofing their Facebook page, it could actually be a scammer that you're engaging with and not your actual friend.
For your kids, you may decide to skip visiting Santa in person this year and use an app for messages or a video call instead. But experts say checking it twice is a must.
Take those few minutes, especially if this is for your child. What are they engaging in? What information are they giving up? And be an informed parent and just review that information.
But the best way to avoid online scams altogether may be just doing your shopping the old-fashioned way.
You get to see the item, you get to touch the item, you get to personally select the item. Downtown is a very safe place to be. I think you can maintain social distancing and still enjoy shopping in a small brick-and-mortar store.
For the NBC2 Investigators, I'm Evan Dean.